So as semi-modulars go, the Proton is definitely one of the most versatile and feature-packed we've created so far. And after recently launching the first video, we had some really great feedback about it from you guys, and a few of you were asking about one of the features in particular. So today we're going to check it out and see how it sounds. It's the Proton Wavefolder. So what is a wavefolder? Well, simply put, a wavefolder is a very specific design of waveshaper. And of course, wavefolding is a type of distortion synthesis where if the input amplitude exceeds a threshold, the peak of the wave gets cut off in the same kind of way you'd get with a clipper. However, instead of clipping off the top and bottom of the wave like a clipper does, with a wavefolder, the peaks get inverted or mirrored into a series of folds, creating complex harmonics and interesting spectra in the process. So on the Proton's wavefolder, there's three controls. There's the symmetry control, which is essentially a DC bias control that causes the top of the waveform to be folded in a different manner to the bottom and in turn altering the timbre. And it also has a CV input over here on the patch bay. Then there's the folds control, which sets the level of the folding and also has its own CV input on the patch bay. And whilst we're on the patch bay here, you'll see there's also a wavefolder audio input and output. Then you've got the mode button. So BP is bypass mode, AM is amplitude modulation mode. And in this mode, the symmetry control has no effect and the fold control simply alters the amplitude of the waveform. Half mode allows both controls to work on the waveform but at half intensity. And finally, there's the one mode, or full mode if you will, and this works the same as half mode, but this time working at full intensity. Okay, so I think the best way to get an idea of what the effect actually does is to see it in action. So let me get my scope up and I'll make some tweaks on a sine wave on a single oscillator so we can clearly see what it's doing. Alright, let's do something a bit more interesting with it. So I'll patch LFO1 into the symmetry and I'll play a sequence and start to bring in another oscillator and just have a general tweak. And I'll also hit the bypass here and there so we can compare the effect.